Did you know that you can upload your own branded fonts directly to Canva and use them in any of your design projects? Canva Pro has some amazing features, and this is one of my all-time favorites. I'm Galen from Local Creative Co., and I use Canva for a lot of things in my web design business. Not only does Canva Pro come with a ton of premium fonts built right into the platform, you can also upload your own branded fonts that you've purchased elsewhere, like Creative Market, or maybe even ones you found through Google Fonts directly. This is really helpful if you've chosen a font to use on your website and you want to use that same font on your social media platforms or maybe on some business cards you're designing in Canva or any other branded assets that you might have. You really want your brand to feel cohesive across all platforms, and using the same fonts is a great way to do that. I have another video out about my favorite font trends right now and some great resources to find premium fonts for your brand, so go check out that video if you're still looking for fonts for your business. Also, leave a few of your favorite fonts in the comments. I would love to see which ones you chose. The first thing you're going to do once you find a font you really love is check the font license. Most people don't talk about this, but when you purchase a font, especially for a business, there are going to be different licenses that that font is under. For example, there's a desktop license, which usually allows you to use a font in print. And then there is a web font license, which lets you use it on your website. And those can sometimes be limited by the number of page views that your site gets every month. So just make sure you pay attention and you read the fine print so you use the font appropriately. A lot of fonts that you may find around the internet are created by small business owners like you and me. So anytime I am buying a font online, I try to see if the font creator has their own website, and I'll try to purchase directly through the creator's website versus through a site like Etsy or Creative Market. Those are wonderful places to find fonts, but they do take a pretty big percentage of every sale. So just keep that in mind. You can do a quick Google search, see if that creator has their own website, and try to purchase through their website if possible. Once you have your font downloaded, I'm going to show you how easy it is to add it to Canva. Let's hop over to my laptop and I'll show you how it's done. Okay, so once you have your font file downloaded, you're going to most likely have it downloaded as a zip file. You're going to double click the zip file to open it, and that is going to bring up a new folder with all of the different font files included. When it comes to Canva, you can upload OTF files, TTF files, or WOFF files. Any of those are fine. This particular font is actually a font duo, meaning it contains two different fonts and actually two versions of one of those fonts. So three fonts total, but I'm just going to be uploading two of them today, and I'm going to show you two different ways to do this from inside of Canva. Once you log into your Canva Pro account, and keep in mind, you do need Canva Pro to be able to upload your own fonts to Canva. And if you want to try out Canva Pro for free, I'm going to include a link in the description below so you can test it out. So once you've logged into your account, you can go over to the left-hand column here and click on Brand Kit. You're going to see a little crown next to this. The little crown used throughout Canva just means that this is a Canva Pro only feature. So you can click on Brand Kit and then come over here to the right. You can see I've already uploaded some fonts here and I've already set my main font styles for my Canva Pro account. I can then click Upload a Font, and I am able to pull this font file directly from the place where it's saved on my computer. So I'm actually going to upload the script version of this font first. I'm going to confirm here. It's going to say by uploading my own custom font, I acknowledge that I own the font or have the right to use it for my intended purposes. That is the license I was referring to earlier. The license is going to tell you, the type of license that you purchase your font for is going to tell you where you can and can't use it. I have purchased the correct version of this, so I'm going to click yes, upload anyway, and give that a second to upload. There we go. Now you can see that font has now been added under my uploaded fonts. There's one more way I'm going to show you that you can do this, and that is from a design itself. So if I'm inside of Canva actively designing a project, I am going to come over to the text that I want to add this new font to. I'm going to click the font drop down here, and at the very bottom, there's an option to upload a font directly. I'm going to click click upload font and then click upload font again. And this time I am going to choose the regular version of this font. We're going to click upload, upload away. And there we go. Let's actually refresh this page. If I click on the font now, come to my font drop down, I am able to see my uploaded fonts here. And you can see I've uploaded quite a few of them. And I'm able to choose the font that I uploaded and actually use it in any of my Canva designs. These are the two fonts that I uploaded. Once I have it here, I'm able to adjust it a little bit, adjust the sizing of my graphic, and that's it. I actually have one more quick tip I want to add in this video. A lot of people love adding custom fonts to their Canva Pro account, but sometimes you've been using Canva for a while, you've been using Canva to design your social graphics, and you find a font that you really love inside of Canva, and you're wondering, can I use that same font on my website, but maybe it's not included as part of your website builder? How do you get a font that's in Canva on your website? I'm a web designer and I recently had a client come to me who had a font that she was using in Canva all the time. And as we redesigned her website, she was wondering if we could use that same font from Canva throughout her website design. The font that she really loved was called Brittany, and it is a default font in Canva, but she wasn't sure how to use the font on her website or basically get it out of Canva. And while you can't get the font out of Canva, you can use Google to find the font creator and purchase the font directly from them. So what I did was I took the name of the font. I was able to go to Google and search Brittany font or Brittany signature font. I was able to find it here on DaFont, and then here is a link to the actual website or the creator's website so that I could purchase the commercial license. So I clicked on that. I ended up on the font creator's website, and then I was able to see all the different types of licenses that they offered with that font. I was then able to send a link directly to my client so they could purchase the font for themselves and share the font file with me so that I could get it set up for them on their website. The two primary platforms I use for web design are Showit and Squarespace. And if you'd like to learn how to add custom fonts to either one of those platforms, let me know in the comments below. I would love to create that video for you next. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any videos I put out in the future. See you next time.